Do you want to build your career in artificial intelligence in the area of medical diagnosis? Yeah, if your answer is yes, then this is the video for you. Hi, my name is Dr. Nitin and I help medical students to clarify their career path towards a better and lucrative opportunities. And if you are visiting this channel for very first time, please subscribe to this channel where I share various tips, tutorial, ideas related to career development, personality development, particularly if you are from medical and healthcare background. So without further delay, let's get started with today's topics. Today we are going to talk about what are the career paths and career opportunities in artificial intelligence in medical diagnosis. So I'll be talking about a very high level. As a medical student, what you can do to develop your career in this field. So, as a medical student, somebody asked me, I'm a medical student and I have a deep interest in artificial intelligence, that is AI, in healthcare, in medical diagnosis. So, I'm replying to that friend, somebody who has asked me this question, anybody who is interested into this kind of medical diagnosis using AI. And if you are somebody who is looking for guidance about what you can do in this field in the future, then this video is for you. So broadly, I would classify somebody interested into this field, either they are looking for a job or maybe they are looking for a business opportunity. So I'll be discussing on paths on broadly on these two high levels. Okay, so let's begin with somebody who is looking for a job in AI healthcare. Okay, so first of all, you need to begin with your education and training. You need to pursue your advanced education in artificial intelligence, maybe machine learning or data science. And especially if you are focusing on applications development in healthcare, okay, then you need to take courses or you need to obtain some certifications in healthcare informatics in order to understand the intersection of healthcare or medical science and the technology, that is artificial intelligence. You need to also gain experience. You can do it by doing some internships or maybe some entry level job positions in companies or in research institutions by working in artificial intelligence in healthcare. Apart from that, you can get involved in projects or research projects related to medical diagnosis algorithms or healthcare data analysis. So these are the some of the high level or preparation steps. Once you feel that you are ready, you need to start networking. You need to attend conferences, workshop, and some networking events related to artificial intelligence in healthcare in order to connect with professionals in the field. You can join various online communities and forum where the discussions are happening about AI in healthcare. You can join those community. You can do it through LinkedIn or you can subscribe to my channel where I share various tutorials related to AI in healthcare. So you can have not subscribed, please subscribe to my channel. You can stay updated with the latest developments in artificial intelligence, machine learning and healthcare by reading various research papers. You can follow some industry blogs and subscribing to relevant newsletters. Okay, I hope you found this information useful till now. If you are not subscribed, please subscribe to my channel and like this video so that it reaches to more and more people who are interested in artificial intelligence in healthcare. Apart from this, you need to develop some skills. You need to participate in programming skills, particularly in language commonly used in AI. Python is kind of one of the significant language. You can learn about data science. You can learn the R. Okay. You can also familiarize yourself with the relevant tools and libraries like TensorFlow, PyTorch, or Skillet Learn. You can socialize considering specializing in specific areas within AI healthcare, such as medical imaging, medical analysis, NLP, that is natural language processing for electronic health records, or maybe predictive analytics for personalized medicine. So these are the some examples. If you want to know more about this, just let me know in the comment section. I would be happy to share more information on this. So these are the some of the high level steps if you are looking for job in artificial intelligence related to medical diagnostics. And if you are somebody who is looking for business opportunities, these are the some of the steps I would share now. You need to begin with identifying your niche or the specialized area. You can do find research areas within healthcare where AI can make significant impact, such as radiology, pathology, maybe genomics or personalized medicine. So you can explore what it does interest you and what are your strengths area. Okay, then what you need to do is that your market research. You need to conduct market research to understand the needs and the challenges faced by healthcare providers in whatever area you have chosen as your niche. Then you need to identify potential competitors and then analyze their offerings, and you need to study your market positioning. The next step would be to develop a solution. You need to work on developing AI-powered product or service that can address a specific need or a pain point in healthcare. Okay, then what you can do is you can collaborate with other healthcare professionals and domain experts in order to, or you can ensure that the solution is clinically relevant and effective. You need to take care of regulatory compliances also. You need to familiarize yourself with healthcare regulations, laws, any updates, compliance standards such as HIPAA, or maybe some regional or local area of compliances where you need to work on, so that your product meets those requirements as per the regulatory requirements. Then you need to build partnership with the other healthcare institutions, particularly medical device companies or maybe pharmaceutical companies, in order to pilot and commercialize your AI solutions. You can do it independently, but it would be better if you collaborate with other AI researchers and data scientists in order to leverage the latest advancements in the technology. While doing this, obviously you are going to need lots of money, so you need to secure your funding. You need to explore what are the funding opportunities through venture capital firms, angel investors, or maybe some government grants which can support your development and commercialization of your AI healthcare business. So once you've done that, you will need some more money for scaling and expanding. Apart from that, you will need that skill also. So once your AI healthcare solution is gaining some traction, you need to explore opportunities to scale your business by expanding into new markets or by offering additional products and services. So these are the some of the basic or high level steps that you can follow in order to achieve a good position or success in either in the job area or in the business acumen related to AI in or artificial intelligence technology in the sector of healthcare innovation diagnostic. So I hope you found this video useful and informative. If you still have any questions, please let me know in the comment section. I would be happy to answer that. Even if you feel that you don't agree with me, let me know in the comment section. what are the points that you are not agreeing with me. I would be happy to discuss on those aspects. And if you found this video useful, please share this video with your friends, your colleagues, so that they are also aware about the different career opportunities in healthcare, particularly in AI field. And if you are not subscribed, I request you to subscribe, because when you subscribe, it gives me a direction that my videos are helping you and giving you some guidance, and this gives me a motivation, right? Because I also need some motivation from you guys. So please do subscribe and share this video with others. That's all for now. We'll meet again in another episode with another topic related to healthcare career. That's all for now. This is Dr. Nitin signing out. Bye bye.